What's up, Independents?
I'm Leah Ryan.
I'm Jonah Raymond.
Welcome to the news.
Soy el fuego que arde tu piel. Soy el agua que mata tu ser. El castillo, la torre, yo soy. La espada que guarda el guadal, tú el aire que respiro yo, y la luz de la luna en el mar, la garganta que se moja, que tema hogar y amor, y cuáles deseos me vas a dar.
Follow the Indy Counseling Department on Twitter for important information on scholarships, student opportunities, testing information, and more. The handle is below.
Williamson County Schools are currently having their Successory Program. It gives students a chance to say thank you to school employees. If you have a particular school employee you would like to thank, pick up a Successory form in the front office and fill it out with the employee you would like to thank. Then drop it off in the box marked Successory Forms. On Friday, a name will be drawn and a prize will be given to that person.
And now, let's send it over to Jalen Abruts for sports.
Good afternoon, Indy Nation. I'm Brooks Howard.
And I'm Jalen Chesson.
And this is your Indy Sports. With spring sports getting into the swing of things,
we have winning records from softball, baseball, soccer, tennis, and the track team is also bringing in wins.
The boys tennis team went 9-0 against Summit, with the girls tennis team going 7-2. The boys soccer team also won 5-0 against Summit this past Wednesday night. Now, let's tune in to see how baseball and softball are both excelling.
Frisbee played at USN 2 weeks ago, with the guys getting third place and the girls getting fourth. Let's go check into the action.
Thank you.
So how long have you been playing Frisbee for?
I've been playing 4 years, so every year of high school.
What positions do you play?
I play handler, which is the position that touches the disc more and starts out the plays. And yeah.
So you're like the starter.
Yeah.
Why did you choose to play Frisbee?
I chose to play because my sister played in high school and she kind of like started it, and our whole family has started to play since, and it's a lot of fun.
Who's the team made up of and who do you guys play against?
So we play against mostly USN, Blackman, and just like the surrounding high schools that actually have a Frisbee team. And we play with a bunch of homeschoolers actually and people from Independence.
That's cool. Since Frisbee is self-officiated, how does that work for you guys?
So us players have to know the rules of the game on and off the field. So when a call gets made on the field, the person who made the call has to know the rules in order for it to be fair. So you really have to have a lot of knowledge of the game and the rules, just so that the spirit of the game stays the same and you don't get too feisty.
So it sounds like Frisbee is a very independent sport. How does that convert into your daily life?
A lot of people depend on you on the field, so you really have to know the game, and you know, it just builds that chemistry between you and the players on the field and your coach and just the other team. So it's kind of intertwined.
That's super cool. Good luck with the rest of your guys this season. Thank you. That's it for this week's Sports Spotlight.
Well, that's it for what? Yeah, no, sports is doing great. Yeah, I know, we're whipping up on Summit. All right, yeah, we're going to have to cut it. Thanks for being a guest on our show. I'm Brooks Howard.
I'm Jalen Chesson.
And we will see y'all next week.
Be sure to check Lost and Found because all items will be donated to charity today. Prom tickets are currently on sale for $35. After spring break, the price will go up to $45. Absolutely no tickets will be sold after April 18th. Prom will be held on Saturday, April 21st.
Students, if you are interested in taking online courses next year, there will be an informational meeting on Tuesday, April 3rd from 6 to 7:30 at Centennial High School. Registration information will be distributed.
The PE class recently held their very own Winter Olympics. Austin Eckert and Josh Stone have more.
What up, guys? It's your boy Jay Stone back with another video for IHS Media.
Yo, what's going on, guys? It's your boy Austin Eckert back again for another video. We're taking it to the gym today.
We're doing human curling.
Yeah. Don't know what that is.
We're gonna find out though.
We're about to find out.
Let's go.
Alright guys, so we're back for day two of the Winter Olympics here at IHS.
Today we're doing bobsledding, I'm pretty sure. It looks pretty fun. Let's go ahead and get out there.
Go.
On the slopes currently, we got Josh in the front. Competition here, competition here. Go, go.
All right. Left, right.
Here we go. We're vlogging. We're going. Get the cone out of the way. This is an action shot. Jackson, are you getting this? Oh, we're gonna win. Oh, we're so winning this. Touch the wall. Go.
Hey, we lost, Brad. We have to finish.
Olympics, baby! Woo!
The following announcements are regarding graduation for seniors. Graduation fees need to be paid in order to receive your cap and gown. Also, please continue logging your community service hours for the recognition of the volunteerism diploma. You need to have 10 hours for each semester. And finally, please forward your college acceptance and scholarship offers to Ms. McCombs in the counseling office, or forward to the email below.
The Sarah Lynn Murphy Memorial Scholarship is now available in the counseling office. The completed application must be submitted to Mrs. Harden in room D221 no later than April 15th. Congratulations to Chloe Copps for winning first place at the Skills USA competition for photography.
We recently had our annual Night of the Arts here in Independence, so I attended the event with Landon Rowles, Ethan Copps, and Sid Creeder. Here's what we saw. Hello, Independence. We're going to get in touch with our artistic side. Let's go. What does Night of the Arts mean to you?
I think it's a display of the fact that sports and stuff like that is not the only thing that Independence has to be proud of, because we have a very good art system and program, so this is what we're proud of, so I think we want to show everyone what we've been working on.
A bunch of different art departments are coming together just for one good night of Night of the Arts. We're just like celebrating the culture of art.
Is there anything that's like really sticking out to you?
I'm looking forward to the fashion show. I'm looking forward to all the performances by the choir, by the theater students, by our orchestra, by our band students.
Will you be partaking in the fashion show?
I'm mostly excited just to see all the wonderful art here. Most of these sketches back over here with all the faces that look really real and like looks really cool. I also like all the digital art of the perspectives.
And now for the Night of the Arts winners. In drawing, Lauren Schwartz for Euphoria. In printmaking, Gavin Terwilliger for CD etching. In sculpture, Estella Pinnell for Automaton. In digital art, Stacy Soriano for Hothead. And multimedia, Logan Bach for Monster.
Painting, Kirsten Maddox, Nature and Mankind. For mixed media, Madison Gabe, Native. Photography, Ashlyn Paws, Through a Lens. Design and illustration, Jonathan Ramirez, Noble Springs Billboard. Congratulations to all the winners. This is Howard's art classes working on an interesting new project. Here's more on that.
Okay, so this project is basically where we kind of picked out like kids, and they're all orphans from Russia, and we draw the kids and then we send them out to them and then in April they'll open them up and look at them, and they'll send us a video back of the kids' reactions, and it's like a really fun thing to see, like the kids looking at it.
My students can see that their art has made a difference and that it's brought a smile to these kids' faces, and so it's just a kind of a cool way to connect artists with kids who need something positive in their life, to know that somebody across the world is thinking about them, that cares about them, to take time to draw a portrait of them. So it's been probably one of the most meaningful projects that we've done. We do it every year. So it's just a great opportunity to see that, you know, their art can make a difference.
Level 1 students Madison Searles and Chloe Copps recently learned about some teachers' furry friends. Here's more on that.
We all know teachers' pets. However, not everybody knows the two teachers who actually have some very unique pets. I'm Madison Searles with IHS News, and today we'll explore the lives of Miss Bolden and Miss Saragusa's not-so-traditional pets.
Though she seldom appears in the classroom, Miss Saragusa's hedgehog, Neil Shubin, is a classroom favorite. Miss Saragusa explains how Neil Shubin found a home in her classroom.
I wanted a class pet, so that way there was a cool animal for the students to look at, and this is definitely an unusual pet. You need hands of steel to hold this pet.
The 4-year-old hedgehog, according to Miss Saragusa, does not find physical activities very alluring. Instead, Neil Shubin prefers to be more introversive.
I like to say that she has a lot in common with a high school student because she does not like light. She's a nocturnal creature. She doesn't like people a lot. She'll curl up in a ball like she is right now.
However, Miss Bolden's pet, a gregarious pig named Finley Jean, has proven to be a great addition to her family, though an unexpected one.
Actually, Finley Jean came into my life by complete accident. She was at a flea market that we were at. She came home with us, and we were told she was a mini pig, and she definitely is not. We were not looking for a pig, but we have her.
Despite Finley Jean being a pig, Miss Bolton describes her mannerisms as similar to that of a dog.
Finley loves to play with our Labradoodle and our weenie dog. She loves to work for treats. She will sit. She will come when her name is called. She loves to make us happy. So, you know, she loves to cuddle, and she loves to spend time with her family.
These teachers have given these pets a home, and in return, they've received a lot of happiness. This has been Madison Searles with IHS News.
Well, Independence, that's all for this week.
Have a good break.